Hi guys, and welcome to this video. This is Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. In this video, we're going to do a bit of advanced CSS styling for our menu. When I say advanced CSS styling, rather than have an effect just happen, we're going to have a bit of movement there. If you look at that home tag up there, look underneath, the actual border has got a bit of movement to it. It's sweeping from left to right. And these are some great effects. There's quite a lot of CSS involved in writing this, but we're going to make it easy today. We're going to go over to a site called Hover CSS, where they've got a whole load of fantastic effects that we can pretty much copy over and customize to our needs, and it'll save a lot of CSS writing. And a particular one I want to use is this one, underlined from left at the moment, and in a future video we're going to do this drop down menu here as well, but for today's we're just going to do this moving underline under our menu items here. So I'll put this link below this video here for the Hover CSS. You can just download it. It's free to download. If you want to use it in a commercial project, you want to look at these licenses here. It's $14 for one project, but it's only $18 for unlimited projects, which, you know, that's the one I'll be going for. And it may sound like a lot of money, but that's going to save me so much time in writing code just to be able to do this. So to download it, just hit the download on GitHub there and hit the clone or download button. Downloads it. Once you've got it downloaded, you're going to end up with a Hovermaster zip here. So just extract it and it'll leave us with this file here. And I'm interested in the CSS, not the less or the SCSS, and so I'm just going to open the Hover cascading style sheet with my bracket software. This bracket software is also free software. I'll put a link for this text editor underneath, and here's our Hover CSS and you just scroll through and it's nicely titled and find the one we want. There it is right there, underlined from left. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy from the top of there till just before the next one, Control C. Now I'm going to go to a different theme here because the one that I was looking at already has it. This is the one we're going to affect menu 3 here, this third menu right here. And let's just put some down under here. We may have to adjust the CSS for the menu afterwards. But if we go to the theme, the dashboard, the theme options, and scroll down to the bottom, and you'll find your custom CSS tab. Scroll down to an appropriate place. I should have a menu 3 here somewhere. There it is. So just under there, I'm going to do the Hover. Although it's got a title, I'm going to give it another title of Hover anyway, because we'll be adding some more to it at a later date. And we'll paste in what we just copied from our brackets here. Now I'm working with the Divi theme here, which is an awesome WordPress theme that keeps getting better and better. They just keep improving it. I've used it on so many projects, it's unbelievable. But this will actually work on any WordPress theme or any theme, whether it's Bootstrap or just pure HTML, because it's pure CSS. You've just got to assign a class to whatever you want it to affect, which is this here, dot hover underline from left. So I'm just going to copy that. If you're using it on any other WordPress theme, you may need to create a child theme. Usually if you customize these things, a lot of themes, you want to create a child theme because when they update the theme, they might overwrite your custom CSS. But Divi here has got a little box for it. And a lot of them do now for your custom CSS here, so it won't get overwritten when it updates. So I've put that in there. I'm going to go ahead and save it. Now for these menu items, I just need to give them the class that I was talking about there, which is the dot hover underline from left. Dot hover underline from left. So I've copied that. Let's go to our menus, which is appearance, themes, and menus. Menu 3, that's the right one right there. Now I've got to give the class. If you open up your menu items, you should see CSS classes there. If you do not see that there, sometimes it's not hidden. You go up to the top on the right hand side, it says screen options. Just check on that. You can check the boxes that you want to be displayed. See CSS classes. So if you make sure that's checked, you will have this little box in there. Okay, that's convenient. So I've just pasted that in there, and just do it to all the other ones that you want it to. I think I've already pasted them in here. Yep, hover underline from left. But you don't need that. Don't need the little dot in front of it. You just need the HVR. And to do that to all the menu items you want. There we go. And let's save the menu. Then go back to our site and do a refresh. Now hopefully when we hover over these, a little line should appear on the bottom. There it is. I'll make it white so you can see it better, but it's actually working there to some extent. Doing kind of what I want, but not totally what I want. So I'm going to have to adjust these menu items here. So let's go back. Let's go back and change our color. Should be a color here. There we are. Background. There's the color. I'll just make that white so we can see it a little easier. FFF. Or for those of you that know, it's FFF, FFF, six Fs, but when it's six of the same, you just need to put the three in. Okay, so we changed that, we saved it back to the site. Should make it a little easier to see now. There we are, you can see that white line underneath. Okay, well, it's done what it promised to do, but that's not what I want. I want it that line a bit closer here off the bottom, and I really only want it the length of one of those items there. So we're gonna have to do a bit of custom CSSing. Let's see what we need to do here. Let's inspect this. I really don't want to subscribe. In an earlier video I made this how to use a plugin to build your email list there. It keeps popping up. Inspect. Okay, that's fine. Let's make sure we got the right thing. Here we go. This is what we want here. Let's change this padding. Try giving it 20 pixels top. I guess I'll leave that important there. It probably needs it. 0 pixels to the right, 20 pixels to the bottom, and 0 pixels to the left. Let's try that. Okay, it's looking a bit fat at the top there. Okay, that's better. You see that line's a bit closer to them right now. Let's just copy that. I just want to get rid of a bit of extra padding there. So I'm going to copy this and put it in our style sheet, in our theme options here. And I'm going to put it in the hover because it's kind of affecting that. And do a quick save back to our site. Let's see what else we're doing. Yeah, you see it's real long there. We want to shorten it up. It's long because the actual list item's kind of long there. So if I change that to a margin, this is margin right rather than padding right, that may be a little bit too long. Yep, it's pushed them down to the next line. Let's try 10. Still pushed it down a little too far. That's all right for the time being. And padding right. We want to make sure we don't have any padding right. Okay, that's better. You see that line? That's brought it, made it a lot shorter, kind of the length of the word, which is what I really wanted there. Padding right. Let's see. I think I can stretch those out a bit more now I've taken that padding away. So let's give it, let's try 12. Nope, too much. Let's try 11. Yeah, that'll work. Okay, so let's take this and copy it over. Back to our custom CSS. I'll just put below that last entry there and do a quick save. Now let's see what we need to do to make it more symmetrical. We'll make that gap a little shorter. So I'm going to change the padding on the actual list item, probably on the anchor tag, which is right there. Yep. That's it. You see that little green section underneath? It's 29 at the moment. Let's bring it back to 20, see what that does. It's getting there. Need to drop it a little bit more. What about 15? Yeah, that looks pretty much right. And there's our little line appearing underneath. That's much more the effect that I wanted there. So let's just save this. Don't need that word wrap, but I'll take the whole lot anyway. Control C. Back to our custom CSS. And just plop that in just below the last entry. And don't need the word wrap because we didn't change that at all. Save our changes. Right, let's close the inspector and refresh, and hopefully that should stay the same. There we go. Okay, so that'll do it. That's our part one in our advanced CSS for our menus here in the Divi theme. As I say, in the next video, we will do our submenu drop down and decorate it like this with images in the background, as well as with that rising effect for the bottom there. So there you have it, guys. That is how to add some advanced CSS transitions to your menu items. I'm using the Divi theme here, but this will work for any WordPress theme or indeed any Bootstrap or HTML theme using a cascading style sheet. So once again, guys, I hope you found that useful. If you have, please subscribe to our channel for more great tips and updates. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.